Hi Ross, good morning. Thank you so much for taking the time out. So I thought instead of writing, I should just show a small video because that'll be efficient. So my first question is, which we discussed, was this Mottigliani-Miller case 2. So we see the VAC is this, right? So we have to include the value of the tax shield. What we have done here is, if you see this formula is further refined like this. So we have replaced the unlevered cost of capital, and this is the amount by which the WACC will be reduced. Like this, the WACC will be reduced by this amount. So my point is, if WACC is reduced by this amount, which is the cost of capital, cost of debt, and the corporate tax rate and DV, then why here, when we talk about in session 8.2 here, the increase in the free cash flow is only cost of debt and corporate tax rate. It should be D divided by V also here, because we know that this is the component by which the WACC will be reduced, and hence the present value of the firm will be increased. So why only we are incorporating this? Why not the debt to value? Because we know that this entire thing, if you RD here and this entire thing, is replaced by RU because of this, that this entire thing is replaced here with RU. So my question is, why DV is not the debt to value ratio is not mentioned here in the increase the cash flow. Thank you.